In order to maintain financial security, you can't rely on one source of income. You need to diversify, and in this video, I'm going to share with you how to do so. How's it going, guys? Ryan here, and today I want to share with you something that I've recently become quite passionate about, and that's developing multiple streams of income to ensure that you are financially secure and you can truly build wealth. One key thing you'll notice with extremely wealthy people is that they have multiple income sources. They don't just work a single job, they've got their money working for them in many different ways. Developing multiple streams of income early on is really critical to your success in the business world as well as in your own finances. So to kick it off, I want to talk about having a single stream of income, and for most people this is a full-time 9-to-5 style job. And the key thing to remember here is this does not provide you with financial security. If you lost that job, you need to understand that you have lost your only stream of revenue into your bank account. Essentially, what you're doing is putting your financial fate in the hands of the business or the person that you work for. And what you need to think about is, okay, if I lost my job right now, how long could I survive? And do I have any other skills or methods of making money to secure my financial position? If the answer is no, then I strongly suggest you start looking into other ways to generate money on the side, even building something small. The best way to do this is through something like passive income, and a really safe way to do it is through investing in dividend paying stocks. Effectively, what you want is to have a second stream of income or a third or fourth stream of income coming in that will allow you to work your full-time job still, but at the same time, if you lost that job, you still have money coming in to pay the bills. The key thing to remember here is nobody got rich from having a single stream of income. Everyone who's wealthy, as I said before, has multiple streams of revenue coming into their bank account, and they're developing them constantly over time. Effectively, what you want to do is essentially use the money from your full-time job to then invest that into your second or third or fourth streams of income. So to start off with, as I mentioned before, you could invest in stocks, you could invest in real estate, you could invest in something just like this, a YouTube channel, and start to develop ad revenue. Now, when we really look into it, you're either going to be in one of two positions. Effectively, you're going to be working a full-time job and you've got disposable income there that you can already use to invest. So you can be investing in stocks, Forex, real estate, all those good things. Now, that's the easiest scenario. You've got some existing money there and disposable income that is slowly accumulating that you can use to invest and create your first, second stream of income. The second scenario is you don't have that disposable income, and as a result, you really need to hustle to be able to even just start developing that disposable income pool. And the absolute best way to do this is to start by educating yourself. If you don't have the funds there right now to start developing a second or third stream of income, then educate yourself. Learn other ways that you can develop a stream of income so that when eventually you do accumulate the disposable income that you need to get started, you can put that to good use and you already know exactly what you're going to do and how you can do it. If you are in this position where you don't have a disposable income available, there are plenty of ways to actually get free money and get started. So a lot of YouTubers promote things like Robinhood and Webull, which are effectively investing apps. And for signing up, you get allocated a free stock worth, I think it's $1 to $1,000 worth in value. It's quite random. And if you get other people signed up through your link and that sort of thing, they also get the similar sort of reward. Basically, what this allows you to do is to start pooling a disposable income and effectively start your first, second passive stream of income without having to do too much. You're simply getting a few people to sign up to a few links. But the key message here is if you're in a scenario where you have the disposable income or you're in a scenario where you don't have the disposable income, You do not want your financial security to be dictated by whether or not you're working at your 9-to-5 job. Ideally, at the start, you want to be doing a bit of research, but you want to sort of delve into things that don't require too much of your attention 24/7, because obviously you're still working that 9-to-5 job, you know. You don't have all that time to dedicate to trading shares every day. You can't be sitting in front of a computer and looking at stocks constantly, you know. So you need to be looking at those things which can be developed on the side. So instead of doing the trading, for instance, you'll be looking at doing long-term investing. So as a result, you can do all your research out of work, but then the rewards pay off over time and you don't really need to manage and maintain the stocks that you're invested in. Now, coming to the end of it, what is the key thing here? What is the ultimate goal? And effectively what that is developing your streams of income to a point where you're able to one day retire from that 9-to-5 job, but still have a decent amount, if not a greater amount of money coming into your bank account. This is effectively, in my mind, the pinnacle of financial security, because your income is dictated by yourself. It's something you've created and something that's consistently coming in and is unaffected by a company or a business. You can effectively move your money around any which way you want to, and you've still got money coming in no matter what. The beauty of this is effectively the amount of income you're making is dictated by the amount of effort you're going to be putting in. So if you go and work a 9-to-5 job and you're getting paid a standard salary of, let's say, $50,000 a year, and you work 8 hours every weekday, if you go into work on a Monday and you do 8 hours of really hard work, then 2 hours of overtime, you're going to get paid whatever your salary is. Now, if you go in on Tuesday the next day and you're completely lazy and don't do too much, you're still going to get paid that same amount of money, because the effort you've put in does not dictate the amount of money you get paid. It's written into your contract. Now, conversely, if we look at other streams of income, for example, small businesses or YouTube channels. So a YouTube channel is probably a great example. The amount of effort you put in dictates the reward you get out of it. So you'll notice a lot of the big YouTubers are uploading constantly. They're constantly putting out content, they're merchandising, they're doing Amazon affiliate marketing, all those sorts of things. And all that effort they're putting in is generating them more money. Now, if they did absolutely nothing at all, you would see that their profits slowly decline. Even the ad revenue would decline. Most of the peak period when they're making money off ad revenue is when they're uploading a new video and when their users get a notification to see they've uploaded and they click and they watch that video. Another great example is investing in the stock market. If you do your research into companies and you understand where you're putting your money and you're looking for good fundamentals and stocks that are clearly going to increase in price, then obviously you're going to profit. As opposed to if you were just putting your money into random stocks willy-nilly, and as a result, you don't really know what you're investing in. More likely than not, you're investing in a dud that either goes down and you lose money, or doesn't really do too much at all. So you really want to put the effort into whatever you're doing in the passive income area. So just to recap, there's 3 key points and steps in this video that you need to take. The first one is realizing that a full-time job does not provide you with financial security. The second is you need to be using the disposable income that you generate from your full-time job to start developing your multiple streams of income. And the third one is eventually you want to be able to build those streams of income to a point where you could easily step away from your 9-to-5 job without having to worry about money at all. Once again, guys, thanks for watching. I really appreciate your support. If you enjoyed the video, please remember to leave a thumbs up and comment any questions down below. And remember, always subscribe if you want to keep up with all the latest content. And with that, have a great day, guys. Cheers.